In this video, we're going to talk about pop-ups and why I rarely build them inside of Webflow. Let's dive in. Hi, I'm Kyle, the creator of No Code Collab, a site with tips, tricks, and tutorials for your next no code project. If you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and visit our website where we have code snippets and other resources to help you during your build. Okay, so when we're talking about pop-ups, I'm specifically talking about the windows that show up when you first visit a web page. Maybe it's got a discount if you subscribe to an email list or a free download or some sort of call to action, but it's the ones that automatically show up. That's what we're talking about. The windows that show up when a user clicks a button or something like that, I'll build those in Webflow all day long. The automated windows, those pop-ups, I like to use third-party tools. And I'll get into that in a second, because I first want to talk about pop-ups because this can be a very controversial topic when it comes to your websites. They're kind of that flashing text of modern websites where if it can be super annoying if you've got too much of it going on. I suppose flashing text was always annoying, but when it comes to pop-ups, they get a bad rap because people have abused using them. They overuse them. You've got a cookie consent and a pop-up, and you've got ads and slide-ins and all these different things, and they never go away. And what'll end up happening is if you overuse pop-ups, people will stop coming to your site. So you have to be very, very careful and very choosy with when you are going to use pop-ups on your site. You just don't want to use them willy-nilly. You need to have a good reason to use a pop-up. That said, pop-ups actually work. People will sign up to newsletters and they will join your email list and they grab people's attention. And so if they are used properly, pop-ups are actually a really good way to get your message out. If you have one thing that you really want people to know, they can be a really good way to do that. You just need to be really careful when you're using them. So the reason that I don't build pop-ups natively in Webflow is because to do them well, they need to have some smarts. You don't want to keep showing people the same pop-up if they keep Xing out of it. They'll get annoyed and they'll never come back. Conversely, if they sign up and you get their email, you don't want to keep showing them the pop-up for the thing that they just signed up for. So you want to have some smarts and you want to be very intentional with when you're showing and when you're not showing this pop-up. And if you do it inside a Webflow, it's much harder to track whether or not a person has dismissed or has signed up and converted. So that's where these third-party tools are super helpful, because they will do all that for you. They'll put a little cookie on the machine and they'll track and they will make sure that you are not bombarding your visitors with these pop-ups when they've shown that they don't want your pop-up, or they did want your pop-up, but no more. So that's why I use the third-party tools. Okay, so when it comes to third-party tools that you can use for pop-ups, you've got a few options. You've got a lot of options. But two free tools that we've talked about on this channel before are Add This and Share This. They're free tools. They do collect information on your users. So if that is something that is of a concern to you, just know that those two do collect data. Two paid tools that I have used before are MailMunch and Tooltip.io. Those two tools also can build really nice pop-ups for you, and they've all got some smarts built in so that you can, if someone dismisses your pop-up, you can determine how long you want to wait before showing your pop-up again, things like that. So those are some of the tools at your disposal. Now, the way these tools work is when you're creating your pop-ups, you go to those tools, you create your pop-ups on those third-party platforms, and then you set them live on those sites. The way that you get them integrated to your website is you just take a bit of code. There's a little embed code that you put onto your site, copy paste that code, and then that code links your site to those third-party tools, and then the third-party tools know which pop-ups to show when someone visits your site. So that was a really quick overview of pop-ups. With great power comes great responsibility. So be sure that you're not overusing pop-ups. But if you do have an important message and you're using them wisely, pop-ups can be a really effective way to build your email list and really get a lot of conversions on your website. So don't be scared of them and just not use them, but please use them with great caution, because you want to make sure that you use them well and you're not detracting from the experience that you've created on your website. I hope this high-level tutorial was helpful and will give you some things to consider when you are building your next pop-ups on your website. Again, if you haven't subscribed already, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and we will see you at the next tutorial.